Susan, thank you so much for coming here to CEIBS, and it's so great to have this opportunity to talk to you. You're a social entrepreneur. You run a company called Power-Solution. So I heard about you because of the World Economic Forum in Davos in January 2024, where you won a social entrepreneur award from the Schwab Foundation. I was so excited to see a social entrepreneur from China, and I reached out to you on LinkedIn and you immediately replied, and our dialogue and conversation has gone on since then. And here we are in Shanghai at CEIBS. So thank you very much for sparing the time. To start with, I'd like to hear a little bit about what is Power Solution. If you can give us a brief overview.
So first of all, thanks for Professor Samin's invitation to be in CEIBS to share our stories. So I'm actually the founder of Power Solution 15 years ago. The last 15 years, I have raised up 4 children, right? 2 girls, 1 boy, and 1 baby company called Power Solution. From day one, we found this Power Solution is providing green energy for a special group of people who still stay in the darkness without any electricity supply. And then in professional world, we say is off-grid areas. And normally these people, the living conditions and also the income is very low. So we provide solar solutions to solve 2 problems. One is the access of electricity by solar, and one is the affordability.
Tell us a little bit about the startup period of the company and the early stage.
The challenge for startup is always the same. You need to find the right customer. You need to define the right product spec. But our challenge is more seriously than the normal companies because we decided to serve, to find the solutions for less privileged populations who is still maybe around the poverty line, and the affordability is the most challenge. I remember 15 years ago, in order to define the right products, I bring the 2 suitcases to travel to Africa to visit a lot of farmers and also to do a lot of field study, also Indian. So in 2009, there is about 1.2 billion people out of power. So until today, there are still about 780 million people still in the off-grid. We have our mission, Power Solution, to serve this BOPs, bottom of pyramid population. But how you convince your partnership, who is local importers or distributors, to join you to deliver to the last mile? Because everybody know as a businessman, to earn the rich people money easier, profit margin is higher. But how you convince your partner to work with you together in local Africa or Indian, and to distribute it in the rural villages is really a challenge. We cannot be smart enough to design the right product in day one. Nobody is a success in day one. I just give you an example, what is the right product design? This product, we name it a candle killer.
A candle killer, yes.
Candle killer, yes. But our partner, Total Energy, give a beautiful name. It's called Pocket Sunshine.
Pocket Sunshine.
Yeah, Pocket Sunshine.
Very nice.
When you see this product, is only 9 parts. The retail price is $5. But the lifespan of product is 5 years. So that means farmers spend $1 1 year for solar energy. So it's charged by solar panel here, and it's lighting here. So we did field research. There are 2 brands. We did a field research. We found out farmers spend $1 to $1.5 1 month for kerosene lamp. And the affordability is one month kerosene lamp, will buy 1 year solar for free. So that means the affordability. But in order to make it affordability is we design this only 9 parts. We cut down the stand because the transportation logistics in last mile is even extremely expensive than the product itself.
Right.
But we don't want the user interface not friendly if the stand is so low. So we make a small innovation, very small innovation. We just make a hook on the stand. And then we found there are so many bottles, Coca-Cola bottles, Pepsi bottles, available in the last mile. So we just hook this stand onto the bottle. As a stand, you may see on the table. This is very good for reading user-friendly. So in this case, we saved a lot of logistics, and to make the cost of the product is $5. This is only example how we design the product. We use as minimum material as possible and then reuse the bottle as a stand available locally. And then we make the batteries inside is replaceable. So we can enlarge the life cycle of the products by easily replacement. We did a lot of research in the field, and to make every cent they spend is countable. That is how we design the products, but this is not success in day one. Today, you see this candle killer is already the fourth version we update.
Right.
The old version may be bigger plastic or the bigger stand and even costly. If you ask me to give advice of the startups how to survive in the first period, don't expect everything is perfect. Move out your leg first and improve day after day. Insist on innovation and improving. And of course, you need to find the right partner. I still remember my first customer from Ethiopia. I convinced him to buy 60 pieces to just one box to put in his container to ship together to Ethiopia. So I told him this is a necessary business because 80% of the population in Ethiopia in 2009 is in rural.
Right.
It's a huge demand. But I'm also not sure because I don't have any success case or proof in Ethiopia people will buy. And then I convinced him to say, why don't you try? There is a big market size. And if you failed, 60 pieces could be for charity. As a rich people, you can help your rural villagers or farmers as a charity, right? When we select our customers, partners, it has to be, has a capital capacity. He is not in the solar business, but he should be have the capital for business. And the second is, it's better he has ready channels to reach out to the villages. Some businessmen may be not in solar in the initially beginning, but they are in the business. They are in the rural business, for example, fertilizer,
right,
seed, and the salt, food. So there are so many partners you need to short it out. It does not mean to say you see everybody is your customer.
Yes.
So in the survival period for the startups, right products, right partner.
Right.
Start from small. Don't expect perfect, and insist on innovation and improved.
So thank you very much. And I will be following your progress with great interest. And I sincerely hope that people in the CEIBS community in China, in Africa, in Europe will find interest in the story, and hopefully some of them will cross paths with you at some point.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. All the very best, Susan.